Hello, we are here at the Alnatura retail store and we're going to talk about sustainability and sensoric, what technology can improve. And I'm not alone here. I'm here today with Stefan Schweiger from Bechtle. Bechtle is a well-known SAP partner and works with different technology partners. Stefan, I'm glad to be here with you. Can you tell us a bit more about Bechtle and what you do together with startups and partners in that area?
At Bechtle, we are actually partnering with big partners like SAP, but also with innovative partners like Axino, which we'll see today, in order to have solutions for IoT and AI, which are, and we will see that later today, which are able to improve sustainability, like energy reduction or food waste reduction. And this is what we see here today.
Okay. I really like that concept of partner-to-partner model because Bechtle is a well-established partner in the ecosystem. You know how the ecosystem at SAP works and you also know the key players in that area of sensoric. But for me, it's a kind of 1+1 concept together with the SAP backend. Yes. Tell me more about Axino. How did you met Axino and how did the partnership came together?
Yes, so actually what we do constantly is that we are looking into the market about highly innovative and added value companies. So that's the reason, or that's the way we found Axino, which is actually a Swiss company, and they have an added value concept, and we like that concept, and we have, as Bechtle, a lot of retail customers, and we said this concept works not only for one customer, but for a whole segment.
I'm now with Ihab from Axino. Ihab, great to meet you. I'm eager to learn more about the challenges from food retailers. What is the difficulty to really keep the food fresh for me like a customer?
One of the main challenges, what we call it, the food quality paradox in the retail industry is actually we need to monitor the quality of the food itself, but we always measure with sensoric only the air temperature. So what we added for that to solve this problem is to have an AI to measure the core temperature continuously for retailers in their coolers. We give the food actually a voice, and the food the cold technician a new set of glasses, so he is able to adjust the cooling equipment to lower the energy consumption at a retailer store.
That's amazing. I remember that one. You give the food a voice, yeah?
Yes.
So basically the food is talking to the sensor.
Exactly.
And then you can measure, yeah? And to really reduce energy and avoid too much food waste.
Exactly.
Yeah? That's
exactly.
Excellent, yeah? Tell me the magic about your AI, yeah? So basically I understood you're measuring not only the air temperature, you're measuring really the core temperature of the product, yeah?
Yes.
And how comes AI in play?
Well, it was a cooperation, no? It was an InnoSwiss project, so subsidized by InnoSwiss. It's a cooperation between Axino and the Zurich University of Applied Science and Migro Zurich, where we worked for a very long time just to see how to detect the core temperature in an enterprise level. So the sensor itself can convert the air temperature within the coolers into core temperature to all different food groups. And we do it in a very simple way. So actually the whole installation and setup is very easy. You can try it yourself.
Really?
If I can open it to you.
Well, that's all I need to measure.
Exactly. Just to put exactly.
White light, yeah?
Exactly.
I don't need cable, nothing? Anything?
No, nothing. Everything
so
is set
just
up.
Just I can do it by myself. Yeah?
Okay. Exactly. So you can just put it. No?
Right.
Upsize. No?
Just put it over there.
Exactly.
Magnetic, yeah?
Exactly.
Awesome, yeah?
That's
done.
That's done the installation.
Okay.
So an installation of a big store will take like max 2 hours. That's it.
Really?
Yes, but it's also very good because it's a retrofit concept, what we developed. So you can also clean the coolers with ease, no? Because you can always remove the sensors and put them again.
Okay.
And this is also from a sustainability point of view, it's a big leap because actually you don't have to replace your existing assets, you can just retrofit an AI system with these sensors as well.
That sounds excellent, yeah. Tell me more about the integration of your sensor data. I assume you collect a lot of data and then you can analyze them. What is the power and maybe future vision to integrate that in back-end systems such as quality management or asset management, yeah, to really kind of even integrate it into procurement systems?
This is exactly what we are doing right now, into integrating our back-end, our AI engine, with the enterprise asset management, for example, like SAP PM, you integrate it to there. So you can control your assets much better from an energy point of view and from to be able to reduce your CO2 emissions per year. So it goes very easy. The sensor itself do deliver the data wirelessly in the whole store here. As you see it, you need only 1 to 2 gateways, that's it. And we take care of the whole data, what you call transmission, to the back end, where it will be calculated, where our alarming engine with the alarming rules, no, is set up to make like a voice text-to-speech alarming to the store itself, and give the whole data again to the enterprise asset management. And from there, you can set the work orders for your technicians to go to specific store to do something, for example. This is the whole thing.
Amazing, yeah. Very inspiring,
thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Very good insight. Thanks for the great conversation.
Thank you for coming here, Christian, and I wish you a safe ride to Davos.
Okay, I'm now going to take some refreshments and then off the ride over Davos.